video we're going to work on the steering wheel controls that came out of a 2002 Cadillac Escalade. They were found in many other GM vehicles such as the Tahoe, Suburban, Yukon, and Olds Bravada, and some Jimmys. You can no longer buy replacements because they have been discontinued. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to take them apart. Here we got this one and this one. They both have two bulbs each in them. And, of course, they're burned out, and we're going to replace them, the bulbs. This is the first time I've attempted this with these switches. So this is going to be a learning experience for both of us. We're going to start with this one here, and we got to find the pins or the connections. There's a point here, 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 and here. You got to pry apart. I'm not sure how this comes apart because I've never done one before. So I'm going to start here and try to pop this out of place and pop this one. It looks like they're coming loose, so we'll just keep working them. Be very careful. You don't want to break the tabs that hold it together. Looks like it's coming apart now. Just keep wiggling this thing till it comes apart. And there, it's coming apart. Okay, here we go. Pull on it very carefully, very easy, because there's little... Oh, there we go. Came apart. There's some little pins in there like the other steering wheel controls that we've done. There's three of them. And they go in this switch. One goes here. Let's try it this way. One goes here. One here. And one here. And those little things push down on the pad here, here, and here. Now let's pull this board out of here. Just grab a hold of it and pull carefully. There we go. There's two bulbs here, and they're in a board or in a holder, and they're surface mounted instead of going through the board. So pull this gray cover off, and now you can see the solder points. It doesn't go through the board, as you can see. Now we need to get our soldering iron. Well, let's first check this to make sure they're dead. We'll put power to them. We got nothing on this one. Nothing on this one. All right, well, let's take these bulbs out. Heat this up. There's a little pad right here. Heat it up and pull up on the bulb on that side only. Turn it around, do the same thing over here. Heat up the pad, pull it up carefully because you can pull it apart. They're not that well made. Just keep heating it and pulling it up till they come right off. Don't pull hard. There's one. Do the same thing for a second ball. Heat it up. Lift one side up carefully. And go to the other side here. Heat this side up and pull carefully. Careful, careful. Oops, I messed this one up. Try to push it back down. I kind of messed this little tracer up, so this one probably won't work. Now we're going to look at the bulbs here. They're just inside this little casing. You just got to pull them out of here once you pull the wires loose. They're kind of wrapped around this little plastic piece. You'll see what I'm talking about when you get it. We'll get, pull the bulb up, and there we go. And we're going to save the little blue filter cap that's on here because you'll need that for your new bulbs. And there we go. One off. Let's do the second one. Same thing. Just kind of get those wires pulled down. Both sides, and now you can pull the bulb right out, take the filter cap off, because you're going to need that. There we go. And there we go. Now I just need to find some bulbs here. Okay. Here are two replacement bulbs. Carefully put the filter caps on. One, put the filter cap on the other bulb. They're kind of hard to put on sometimes, but they go on. Now we got to pull these leads apart so we can squeeze it down into this little piece. Get it down in here. Helps not to have real big hands like mine. Got to get down in there, seated. I'll try. My hands are just so big I can't hardly hold on to it. It's easy. Pull the wires down. You'll see little grooves in this thing where the wire has to go. Once you can get it in there. It's really not that hard, but I'm having a hard time with my big hands here. Filter, there we go. And kind of wrap it back behind it and you can cut them off. Here, let's get these pulled back a little more. Okay, let's cut a little of this off. We don't need near as much wire sticking out. Cut it pretty short because you only got to solder it back on this little board. I'll do the same here for your. Well, fix this one real quick. Okay, now let's do the second one. Spread the wires apart. Stick it down in the little holder. Kind of got to get it way down in there so it's sitting on the bottom. And the wires are sticking out. And bend them and wrap them around. You'll see little grooves here. There's a groove right. I don't know if you can see it. Right there is a little groove that the wire goes in on both sides. So wrap it through there. Bring it to the back. Cut them short. Careful. And you need to bend them just a hair. And put them on this board. Let's see here. Bend these wires back a little. This junk out of the way. Now I'm going to use my little vise here. I love this thing. Found it on eBay. It helps hold these boards into place. Because I got such big hands and it holds it nice and steady for me. Get in here, don't tighten it up too much or you'll break it. You don't need this if you've got better, you know, steady hands. I just use this because it's easier. I messed this pad up a little bit there. Knew that would happen. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is put a little extra solder on all these pads. Do all four of them. Okay, now we're ready to put the bulbs in. Grab it carefully. Set it down on the board. Once you get the wires right. Let's put the first one in here, set it down on the board. Make sure the wires are touching both those little pads. It's hard to see in this video, but there's two little pads that it solders to. Now we're just going to hit it here and get it soldered. Let it dry before you let go. Same thing on both sides. Kind of heat it up. Hold it for a second. There you go. And voila. Do same thing for second one. Yeah. Here I go with my big hands again. Got the lines bent the wrong way. All right. Cut a little of this off. It's too much. You don't need much wire here. You'll see what I'm talking about when you pull the old ones out. All right, set it here. Nice and straight. So you don't look like you're drunk. Grab your soldering iron. Just warm up, heat up the solder, and it'll stick. And then go do the other side. Heat it up. Hang on to it for a second. And voila. This one's a little loose because I broke the pad. It probably won't work. But that's okay. Just don't be as rough as I was. I pulled on it a little too hard. Just heat it up and pull it out. Don't pull it so hard. I pulled a little too hard. Didn't know. First time I've ever done one. All right. Now we're going to put this thing back together. Now let me test it first. See if they work. Let's see here. We got light. Yep, that one works. And that one works, but I think I messed up the pad. And doesn't look good. Yeah, well, I'm not going to worry about it. We'll put it back together anyway. Okay, here's the backing. We'll put this gray pad back on here. It'll only go on one way correctly. And just kind of push it down into the little holes here. There's little holes that this gray pad will go through to kind of hold it in place. Get it together. Get a little excess wire there. Kind of bend it up so it isn't blocking the hole. And we'll push this pad back down on it. Okay, now we'll put it in here. Get it down in there. All right, now pick up the buttons. Be careful, make sure all those little pins are in there. Like that one. Make sure all three of them are in place. Hold it this way so you don't dump them out, and then we'll just push this onto the button. Snap it together. Come on. There we go. And now they work nice and smooth. Now we'll start with the second switch. I already got it out of the switch. The board anyway. And now we're going to do the same thing with it. I've already removed the bulbs. And these are the new ones we're going to put in. These wires bent the correct way. Okay. Got those. Now we're going to do the same thing again. Put a little extra solder on all four of the little soldering pads. One, two, three, and four. Yeah, nice and smooth. And we do the same thing we did on the last one. Just make sure these little wires are just right. Set it on here. Solder it into place. One. Get over here, solder this side. came loose. Don't like that. All right, whoops, don't do that either. I hate it when I drop a bulb. All right, now we got it back. We'll put it in here. Messed it up dropping it. I'll set it on here. Same procedure, get your soldering iron, heat it up. That one's in. Do it to the other side. Solder it into place. And there we go. Looks pretty good. Yep, this one's pretty good. Didn't mess this one up. And we'll take it out of here. And what did I do with the switch cover? Where is it? It's somewhere in this mess. Nope, not under here. Oh boy, what'd I do? I got it here somewhere. Oh, here it is. All right. And now I'm missing the pins. There's one. Oh, here they are, two and three. All right, same thing, put the pins back into the board, or the switch. One, two, three. And do the same thing again with this board. Put the little gray cover back on. Make sure it pops into the little holes in the board. They're just like little tabs that stick up, little rubber tabs. They just kind of pop in these little holes to hold it in place, like so. Then push it down. Put it in the board like we did, or in the switch like we did the other one. Just slide it in here. It only goes in one way, so you can't really screw it up. And push it down in here. There we go. All right, now we'll do the same thing. Flip it over and put the cover on the switch. And then start squeezing it back together. And it looks good. Now the buttons seem to work. Yep. Feel good. You can feel them moving. So now what we're going to do, we're going to plug it up to this harness I have. And let's see. We got them both plugged up. That one I messed up. So let's see here. We'll turn off some of the lights so we can turn this on and see how they look. All right, I don't know if you can see it too well, but there you go. We have lights again. This one, the one I messed up, I think. Yep, can't see the lights as well. See, kind of not dark enough in here either, but they are lit up. Push it, there we go. This one lights up nice. Switch works. There you can see the lights. This one would have been just as good if I didn't mess up the little pad on it. Well, that's pretty much it.